Okay, welcome back to the video sessions of standard costing and variance analysis. Number one video already completed and we have uploaded into the system. In that video, we discussed how to identify basic variances and what is the meaning of variance analysis, right? That's all the part we have covered. I told you in that video, we have to this part that at that video I told you that area will not be tested, but it will be required to analyze other questions will be tested in the exam. Therefore, from now onward, we will discuss exam focus areas of the syllabus, right? In this variance analysis part, the most important two areas you have to discuss, that is mix and yield variance as well as planning and operational variances. These are the examinable area in the syllabus. However, you have to use that knowledge we discuss in the first video. Okay, let's start today this sessions to discuss mix and yield variance. I will use your study text also. Therefore, while you watching, it is better to use the study text also. All right. The advance variance analysis. Right. This is the topic, but this topic not available in the study text. I will have create this advanced variance analysis, because in the video number one we discussed basic ratio variance analysis. Under the advanced variance analysis number one, that is mixed and yield, the two wordings very important, mixed and yield variance, right. In your syllabus, this is basically calculate using direct material and direct labor, right. First, I will tell what is mixed and yield variance. Let's start with direct material. The direct material cost variance, I think you can remember, we have divided this into two categories. The price variance, direct material price variance, and direct material usage variance. Right. If I take the formula we have developed, as well as you know, we have discussed how to calculate in practically, the formula wise, it is standard price minus actual price, because it talks about the price variance, then multiplied by actual quantity, right. When it's come to the usage variance, within bracket you have to take the usage, that is standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. Now, this is the basic variances relating to the direct material. See what we are going to learn now, mix variance and yield variance. Let's start with mix. What is mix? Mix means when you are using more than one type of material. When you using more than one type of material item, material A, material B, material C, likewise, the production will include a mix of material. When you producing, example, assume you producing something, this is production process, you input, this is input, material A. Right, this is input, you will receive the output, output is the finished good. Within this finished good, according to this diagram, you have only one material. Therefore, within this finished good, it consists A, say the bread's production, is this a bread, this bread include wheat flour, right. Therefore, in this type of scenario, no need to calculate mix variance, since production process involve only one item of material. But see like this, the production process require more than one type of material, material A, material B, say another material, material C. Now, this finished good consists three items, not only one, right. Therefore, within this finished good, you have a combination of A, B, and C. This combination called mix. Now, we are going to talk about mix variance. What is mix variance? When you are going to produce this product, you will be able to make a mix of these three raw material into the finished product or production process. Therefore, you can identify a planned mix, maybe like this, 10% of A, 40% of B, and 50% of C. That will be the mix. You can have a planned mix, but at the end of the production process, that percentage not available there. Say like this, you will plan to have 10% of A, 40% of B, and 50% of C. That means, according to the plan, within this finished product, it should be 40, 10 and 50% A, B and C respectively. However, once you receive the finished good, you will identify 15% of A, 35% of C, B and 50% of C is available. Now, this is the actual mix, the finally the realized mix. This is the planned mix. The difference between the planned mix and the actual mix called mix variance. Therefore, to calculate the mix variance, you need the planned mix as well as the actual mix. What is this actual mix? Actual mix means what is the percentage? What is the percentage actually introduced into the production process? Actual percentage introduced into the production process. This is the planned percentage. You plan to introduce like this, but actually you introduce this much. The difference is the mix variance. Is that clear? Right. That's why I told you to learn these advanced aspects of variances, you require to understand the basic variance calculations. Now, let's see how to calculate this mix and yield variance. Theoretically, I can tell like this. This is the usage variance. Theoretically, mix and yield variance means the bifurcation of the main usage variance. That means usage variance. The answer you will receive as the usage variance can be bifurcated as mix variance and yield variance. That means this variance calculation will divide into two sub formula. Is that clear? This basic usage variance calculation will be divided into two sub formula, that's called mix and yield variance. Let's see how we can do this. Now, you know basic usage variance is standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. When they are using more than one raw material item, you know standard quantity, not only from one unit of item, it is from more than one unit of item. Actual quantity also, not only from one unit of item, it is more than one unit of item. Therefore, this need to be divided into two. Then you can identify one variance here, another variance here. That two variance are the mix variance and yield variance. Clear? Now, let's see how we can bifurcate this basic variance into two variances. Here, you have the standard quantity. Look this. We can rewrite standard quantity into standard mix. the standard quantity according to the standard mix. The end of the formula, this one, will be actual quantity into actual mix, right? The same wording, just expanded standard quantity into standard mix. Yes, because it's standard quantity, this is actual quantity, therefore actual quantity into actual mix. To the middle of the formula, you will introduce actual quantity into standard mix. Got it? Actual quantity into standard mix. Now you can see you have two sub formulas. This is one difference, the other one I will take the blue color. This is the other one. If you take these two separately, what happened? We have introduced additional number into the middle, right? Let's take separately this as one, this as one. This is actual quantity into standard mix minus actual quantity into actual mix. Outside you have always standard price. If you take this, standard quantity into standard mix minus actual quantity into standard mix multiplied by standard price. Now you can see how this basic usage formula divided into two formula as mix and yield variance. Now let's see what is mix variance and what is yield variance. Look this formula. In this formula, the variance can be identified within the bracket. Here actual quantity, this both same. But this is standard mix, this is actual mix. Therefore, the difference is the mix. Therefore, this will be identified as mix variance. When it's come to here, you can see the mix is same, standard mix, but quantity is different, standard quantity and actual quantity. Therefore, this will be identified as yield variance. Now you can see how we can easily identify two formula for mix and yield variance. If you have this formula in your mind, easily you can create mix and yield formula. This is for material, same as for the labor. How, why? In labor also, you may use, the production process may use more than one item of labor, skilled labor, unskilled labor, internship labor, likewise different labor categories you can use in the production process. When you are using more than one category of labor, you have to go to this mix and yield variance. Let's see that part also. Okay, let's see mix and yield variance for labor as we mentioned here. You know, basically, direct labor variance, labor cost variance. According to the basic variance, it can be divided into two, rate variance and efficiency variance. If you remind the formula, the rate, you need to take the difference of rate here, that is standard rate minus actual rate into actual hours, since it is labor. Here, the efficiency is the quantity, that is standard hours minus actual hours into standard rate. This is the basic variance. Now, as I explained in material, how you can divide, how you can identify the mix and yield variance? Again, it will arise here. Mix and yield variance. I will take here yield variance, here mix variance. What you have to do? You have to introduce actual hours into standard mix here. The reason is, when you take this basic formula, This is standard hours into standard mix. This is actual hours into actual mix, because both standard and actual. Therefore, when you have more than one type of labor, standard hours will taken as with the standard mix. Actual hours will be taken with actual mix. Now, what to divide this into two formula as yield and mix, you need to introduce one thing into the middle, right? Then you can have yield variance and mix variance, right? Let's start from here. Standard hours into standard mix minus one, the things you are going to introduce here, right? Then the formula here started with that, then multiplied by standard rate. In this case, the things you introduce here will come here, then minus actual hours into actual mix into standard rate. Now, what you are going to introduce into the middle? This is actual hours into actual mix. Now, take actual hours into standard mix. Actual hours into standard mix. That is actual hours into standard mix. Now, in this case, see, actual hours, these two same, but standard mix and actual mix, therefore, difference is the mix variance. Very easily you can develop this. In this case, actual hours, standard hours, different is the hours, standard mix is same in both case, therefore, it is yield variance. That's how you can develop mix and yield variance for direct material and labor. Our next task is to have an example to discuss this. Let's move into the white screen, the computer screen, then we can discuss using our study task. Okay, now you are getting the screen, the mix and yield variance. This is according to your study text, chapter 6, standard costing and variance analysis, mix and yield variance. Let's see the description given. The material usage variance can be subdivided into material mix variance and material yield variance when more than one material is used in the product. I think now you can remember what I have explained to you. If more than one type of labor is used in the product, the labor efficiency variance can be analyzed further into labor mix variance and labor yield variance. The sales volume profit variance also can divide into sales mix and sales quantity variance. That is sales variance. Let's discuss it is separately. Now, let's take an example to understand this. This is the example available in your study text. Let's read the example, then we can use whiteboard and we can use the answer also available in the study text to analyze the theoretical point we have discussed. A company manufactures a chemical dynamite using two compounds. See, they are using two types of material items, flash and bang. The standard material usage and cost of one unit of dynamite are as follows. That is, standard cost card is given, because standard cost card given with one unit basis. Flash, the one type of material, 5 kilograms required, 2000 rupees per kilogram. Then bang, 10 kilograms required, 3000 rupees per kilogram. In a particular period, 80 units of dynamite were produced from 5000 kilograms of flash and 730 kilograms of bang. Required, calculate material usage, that is the basic variance, then the division of that usage variance, that is mix and yield variance. First, you can calculate the usage variance, thereafter you can go to the mix and yield variance. Now, what is the usage variance formula? Let's take the whiteboard again to calculate it using our knowledge we have gathered in the video number 1. Now, you know material usage variance. This is a basic variance, right? Material usage variance. Our formula was standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. But we are not going to use the same formula. We can use the sentences to calculate, or you can use the formula also. Let's try to calculate the basic variance of usage. The standard quantity. Now, you know we have two material items, plash and ban. Therefore, we need two formula. What means standard quantity? We have produced actually 80 units. We have produced 80 units, right? We expected to use 5 kilograms of plash and 10 kilograms of ban. These are the standard quantities we expected to use for one unit. But we produce actually 80 units. Therefore, answer for this is the standard quantity. This is the standard quantity calculation. Now, we need to deduct actual quantity here. Let's take actual quantity. Actual quantity directly given, it is 500 kilograms of plash already used and 730 kilograms of ban already used. This difference need to be multiplied by standard price, 2000 rupees per 1 kilogram of plash, 3000 rupees per 1 kilogram of ban. The answer will be the usage variance, the basic usage variance. Let's calculate this. I think Suraj will give me the calculator. We know in each, you have job costing in your syllabus. This is an additional example, right? We have job costing in the syllabus. In every job, you know, we have essential important machineries, labor, and less important machineries and labors for a job. For this CA webinar process, the essential labor is Suraj. More than the lecturer, why? He will bring everything, calculator, camera, everything. One day I try to bring him to in front of you, because he always behind the camera. But you must know him, because finally you have to blame everything to him. You can't contact us, you can contact him every time, because he is available in the office, CA Sri Lanka office. Okay, moving into the lecture again. Let's calculate the answer. We have expected to use 5 kilograms and 10 kilograms of F and B, one unit. We produce 80,000, therefore, this is the standard usage. This is the actual usage, actual quantity purchased and used. Multiplied by, difference will be multiplied by the standard price. Let's see. 80 into 5 means 400, minus 500, then minus 100 into 2000, minus 200,000. 200,000 minus, that is adverse variance, then 800 minus 730 plus 70 into 3000, it is favorable, 210,000 favorable. Final result, value in rupees, 10,000 favorable, right? Let's move into our answer and let's see the screen whether they have calculated it correctly as we calculated. Yes, on the screen you can see the usage variance as a total, the usage variance favorable 10,000. They have calculated here as 10,000, right? Now, we have to calculate mix and yield variance. You can see on the screen they have calculated both mix and yield variance. This is the calculation of mix variance, right? Now, remember, what we have discussed in the calculation of mix and yield variance. Moving into the whiteboard again, now we are going to calculate mix and yield variance according to our explanation. I have told you the mix and yield variance is the bifurcation of this, got it? Subdivision of usage variance. Usage variance in the basic variance, mix and yield variance is the subdivision of this usage variance. This can be subdivided into yield and mix. The follow my method. I have taken yield as number 1 and mix as number 2. Don't take mix first and yield later, because this way of writing also helpful to identify the formula, right? First take yield variance, secondly take, I will put the number, right? This is number 1, take yield variance, this is number 2, take mix variance, right? Subdivision of this 10,000. I told you the yield and mix variance will arise when you introduce one thing into the middle of the basic formula. Now, once you introduce something into the middle, this will be go to the beginning, this will be go to the end, right? Therefore, yield variance you can start with this standard quantity. Since you have more than one item of raw material, you can say standard quantity into standard mix, standard quantity into standard mix here. Actual quantity into actual mix, this is the actual formula, basic formula. Standard quantity always taken with the standard mix, actual quantity always taken with actual mix. Therefore, this one will be taken as the number 1 of yield formula. Then, you can't take this because you will introduce something into the middle here. Then you will have additional formula. Therefore, you need to keep a blank here, multiplied by standard rate. When it comes to mix variance, again multiplied by standard rate, the end item you have actual mix, actual quantity into actual mix. Now you need to learn what you are going to introduce into the middle to have the yield and mix variance. Here and here we have to introduce only one, then it will be bifurcated into two. What you have to introduce, keep your mind, you will introduce actual quantity into standard mix, not into actual mix, standard mix. That is the only thing you need to keep your mind, actual quantity into standard mix. Now see, you have the two formula for yield variance and mix variance. Let's calculate after introducing figures into the formula. You know we have two items of material, F and B. Standard quantity into standard mix. This is the standard quantity into standard mix, 80 into 5, 400, 80 into 10, 800. Right? In this case also, we have F and B. We can take actual quantity into actual mix is the last two item. It will be here 500 and 730. Now you need to identify this newly introduced item, that is actual quantity into standard mix. What was the actual quantity? Sum of these two. Actual quantity is sum of these two. How much? 30 and 12, 1230. Yeah. Actual quantity is 1230 should be in standard mix. Keep in your mind. Actual quantity as a total, the sum of these 2230, it should be in standard mix. What is standard mix? This is the standard mix, 5 to 10. Why? They plan to produce one unit with 5 kilograms of flash and 10 kilograms of bang. that's how they plan to produce one unit. Therefore, standard mix will be 5 to 10, right? That is, the total is 15. 5 out of 15 and 10 out of 15, that is 1/3 and 2/3. Therefore, mix will be 1/3 and 2/3. You have to divide this by 3, 1 and 2. 1230 divided by 3. Sorry, 1 for flash, 2 for bang. 1230, once you divide by 3, 410. Therefore, 1/3, 410 and 820. 410 and 820, 1/3. Sorry, 1 to 2, right? That is the ratio, 1 to 2. 5 to 10 means 1 to 2. Now, we can use the same standard rates. Here 2000 rupees, here 3000 rupees. Here also 2000 rupees the rate and 3000 rupees is the rate. Let's have the answers. Minus 10 into 2000, 2000 into 10. 20,000 adverse, 20,000 adverse, then minus 20 into 3,000, minus 20 into 3,000, that is 60,000 adverse. Therefore, total yield variance will be 80,000 adverse. Let's take mix variance. 410 minus 500 into 2000, 410 minus 500 into 2000, that is 180,000 adverse, adverse here. 820 minus 730 into 3000, it's a favorable variance, 270,000 favorable variance. Then total will be favorable variance minus 180,000, that is 90,000 favorable. 90,000 favorable, see this, I think you can appear the answer. Yield variance 80,000 adverse minus mix variance 90,000 favorable. Clear? See the answer carefully. Mix variance minus 80,000 because it is adverse. Yield variance minus 80,000. Mix variance plus 90,000. I told you basically this yield and mix variance is the bifurcation of basic usage variance after introducing additional thing into the middle, right? I think you can remember. Therefore, the sum of these two answers would be this answer. Clear? Sum of yield variance and mix variance would be this answer. Yes, it was. Minus 80 plus 90 will be plus 10,000. That's why I told you at the beginning, the mix and yield variance basically will be calculated for the material and labor here. We'll discuss for the sales separately. Basically, for cost, you will calculate for material and labor. Mix and yield will arise when you use more than one item of material or labor. That is the bifurcation of for material usage variance, for labor efficiency variance. Therefore, the sum of yield and mix variance would be the answer of the basic variance for material usage, for labor, that is efficiency. I think you got the meaning. meaning of this. Let us have another example for labor now. Still we are in the calculation of mix and yield variance, right. Let us have an example for labor. I will take the computer screen again, use your study text. There is another example for material, better to have calculate it also, because practicing mock question is better. Therefore, before moving into the labor example, let us take the next example available in the study text. I think you can see that after this example, the next example appearing. Now, this is the next example. Again, it is for material, no issue. Let us discuss that question also, right. I am not going to calculate. If I for some instances, I will explain with the calculation. For other cases, let us have the screen, right. The second example for material, they have two types of material, material X and material Y. For the one unit, this is standard cost card, right. Here, this is the standard cost card. One unit require 3 kilogram of X and 5 kilograms of Y. The price 2000 and 3600 per kilogram. During the period, these are the actual information. During the period 2, right, during the period 2, 2000 kilograms of X, total value 4.1 million rupees. 2400 kilograms of Y, total value 9.6 million rupees were used to produce 500 units of finished good, right. They are asking us to calculate price variance, mix variance and yield variance in total and for each individual material, right. Using this information, let us use the board now, because in the board we can easily explain it. The calculation. Now, they are asking us to calculate all the variances of material. You know, direct material cost variance, right? Direct material cost variance. Basically, we will divide into two categories, price variance and usage variance. First, let us calculate price and usage variance. I think some information not available, therefore, let us try to calculate as much as possible. The price variance basically standard price minus actual price into actual quantity. Clear? You know, we have two items X and Y. the standard price per unit, it is given as 2000 rupees and 3600 rupees. The standard price not given because they have given the total cost, but you know when you have the total cost by dividing quantity you can have the actual price. For X they incurred 4.1 million as total cost, quantity purchase 2000. Now we have the actual price here. For Y they incurred 9.6 million rupees to buy 2400 kilograms. Now you can have actual prices. These are the standard prices, these are the actual prices. Then you will multiply it by actual quantity here 2000, here actual quantity 2400. Oh, I have told you in a simple way you can calculate, because once you multiply the actual quantity with the standard price, you have answer for these two. Then these 4.1 million can be taken as the sum of actual price and actual quantity. Then easily you can take the difference also, that is mathematics, right? Or you can use this method to have the answer. Let's see the value. 4.1 million divided by 2000. That is 2050. Therefore, we can say X 2000 minus 2015 to 2000, it is equal 15 to 2000 minus 15 to 2000, that is 100,000 rupees adverse. The Y 306,000 minus 9.6 million into divide by 2400, that is 4000 into 2400 kilograms. Again adverse, I think, yes, 400 adverse into 2400, answer will be 960,000 adverse. Total price variance will be 1,060,000 adverse. Let's see the answer on the screen now. Question A, we can see that for material AX, the adverse variance in 1000, 100, that is 100,000 adverse variance. Then for material Y, the adverse variance 960,000 altogether, that is 1,060,000. Moving into the whiteboard, you can see the separated answer for the both item and the total answer. That's how you have to calculate the price variance for the given question, that is material price variance. Now let's move into the usage variance. See the question. Question clearly mentioned you require to calculate not the usage variance. They ask you to calculate yield and mix variance. Therefore, no need to calculate this, since we are calculating their bifurcation. The sum of that two sub variances can be considered as the usage variance. Therefore, only for the calculation purpose, let's write down the formula of usage. Usage is the quantity. Therefore, it's standard quantity, but since they have more than one quantity, standard quantity to standard mix minus actual quantity, since they have more than one item, actual mix is to standard price. But examiner asks us to calculate the bifurcation of these two. The bifurcation means the yield variance and mix variance, right? You know, once you introduce one number into the middle, you can have the two variances. Therefore, you will start from here, standard quantity into standard mix minus standard quantity into standard mix minus the thing you introducing, you will introduce actual quantity into standard mix. I think you can remember, then standard price. When it comes to the mix, the last item will be the last, that is actual quantity into actual mix. The beginning item will be the introduced item, that is actual quantity into standard mix, the standard price. Now let's introduce numbers according to the question. I will take the question, you also can use your study text. The number one is standard quantity into standard mix. According to the question, they have given, they have mentioned, they have produced 5000 units, right? They have produced 5000 units using X and Y. Let's take X and Y. 500 units, sorry, they have produced 500 unit. They were expected to use 3 kilograms of X and 5 kilograms of Y. That is the standard quantity into standard mix, right? Then actual quantity into standard mix, the actual quantity was from X and Y 2000 and 2400, total 4400. Now this actual quantity should be taken according to the standard mix. That means this 4400 should be allocated among the standard mix, that is 3 to 5 is the total is 8. Divide by 8, then 3 4 x, 5 4 y. Let's divide 4400 by 8. Answer 550. Once you divide this, answer will be 550. Then 3 part 4 x, 5 part 4 y. Then 550 into 2 3, 1650. Then 5 parts 4 y, 550 for 5, 2750. However, finally, you have allocated actual quantity into standard mix, 0044. You can see that. Then you will multiply it by standard price, 2000 rupees, and 2400 rupees. Yes, price also 3600 rupees. Here also price would be 3600. I mistakenly have taken 2400 as the price, that is 3600, right? Let's see whether this is correct, because mistakenly I have taken this, that would be 3600. Then what will happen? Let's check this. 9.6 million divided by 2400 minus 3600. Here quantity, that is correct. I was make the mistake. That is correct. The remain figure is correct. Don't change it. Because here the price variance, I was made the mistake, price variance, therefore this is the quantity, that the quantity is correct, very sorry, right. Now here price, this is not the price because we have used the quantity, I have made the mistake, don't change it, right, keep as it is, this is correct, originally calculated answer is correct, right, right. When here the price 3600, let's see the answers for the yield variance. 5000 into 3 means 1500. Here 1650, that is 150 excess, 150 adverse into 2000, that is 300,000 adverse. Here 2500, here 2500, 2750 means 250 minus 250 minus into 3600, that is 900,000 adverse. then total 1.2 million adverse yield variance. Now, let us calculate mix variance. What is the formula? We have two items x and y. Actual quantity into standard mix, this is already calculated. Actual quantity into standard mix 1650, 2750 minus actual quantity into actual mix, it was already taken. Actual quantity into actual mix, that is 2000 and 2400, actual quantity into actual mix, the actual information 2000 and 2400 multiplied by standard prices 2000 rupees and 3600 rupees. Let us have two answers here for x and y, and let us take the total. Here 1650 minus 2000, 1650 minus 2000, adverse 350 into 2000, adverse 700,000, adverse 700,000. Here 2750 minus 2400, that is favorable 350 into 3600, that is 1,260,000 favorable. Their final answer will be 560,000 favorable. Now, mix variance 560 favorable, yield variance 1.2 million adverse. Therefore, final usage variance is the sum of these two. The usage variance would be sum of yield and mix variance. Yield variance 1.2 million adverse, mix variance 560,000 favorable. Therefore, usage variance will be 1.2 million, that is 640,000 adverse. This is the answer for the examiner raised question. They raise us to calculate mix variance and yield variance. Now, let us move into the computer screen to see the answer given in the study test. Here you can see the yield variance 1.2 million in 1000 figures, 1.2 million adverse. This is the yield variance, right? This is the yield variance 1.2 million adverse. Then this is the mix variance 560,000 favorable, as we discussed in the whiteboard. Okay. Now let us move into the next example given in the study text for mixed and yield. Again is a material example, therefore, I would like to mix skip that example because we have already discussed two questions for material. Let us move into a labor example. No, unfortunately, yeah, labor mix and yield variance also given. The topic is 3.8, you can see it is in the study text. Let us directly take an example to discuss the labor mix and yield variances. This is the question. Let us read the question for labor mix and yield. Two grades of labor works together in teams of produce product X. Two type of labor they are using. The standard composition of each team is 5 grade A employees paid rupees 6000 per hour and 3 grade B employees paid rupees 4000 per hour. They have 2 grades of employees, A grade and B grade. For A grade employees, they will pay 6000 rupees per hour. For B grade employees, they will pay 4000 rupees per hour. That is the standard rate per hour. Output is measured in standard hours and expected output is 95 standard hours for 100 hours worked in total. During the last period, 2280 standard hours of output were produced using 1500 hours of grade A labor, costing 9750 in 1000 and 852 hours of grade B labor, costing 2,982,000 or 2.9282 million rupees, right? That is the cost. Calculate possible labor variances, right? Now, when they are giving labor mix and labor yield variances, you require under the labor mix and yield variance, you require to calculate all possible variances. Moving into the whiteboard again, here we can calculate the labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance, basic two labor variances. Thereafter, efficiency variance we can divide into mix variance and yield variance. Let's see how we can do this, right? I will now summarize entire question on the whiteboard to take summary list of information for the calculation purpose. Let's read the question again and summary the question on the whiteboard. Now, I will summarize the question on the whiteboard. 2 grades of employees, they have 2 grades of employees, employee A and employee B. Per hour, they will pay per hour for A grade 6000 rupees, they will pay. For B grade employees, they will pay 4000 per hour. Right, this is the payment per hour. Output is measured in standard hours and expected output is 95 standard hours for 100 hours worked in total. Now, here they have expected to have 95 standard hours, that is the output, right? That is the output, 95 standard hours for 100 hours worked in total. During the last period, 2280 standard hours of output were produced using 1500 hours of grade A for the costing of 9.75 million and 852 hours of grade B labor costing 2.982 million rupees. Now, here you need to find out what is the standard. Clear? What is the standard quantity in the mix, labor mix? That is very important to clear to understand, right? Now, they mention after the labor hour cost, output is measured in standard hours and expected output is 95 standard hours for 100 hours worked in total. Clear? During the last period, 2280 hours, standard hours of output were produced using 1500 of hours of A and 852 hours of B. That is actual information, right? Now, what you need to do, you need to summarize this actual information also, right? That is very important to understand. Let's summarize the actual information. This is standard information, standard cost card. Let's take the actual information. Actual information was, were produced 1500 hours of A and 852 hours of B. Then A grade employees and B grade employees were worked actually 1500 hours and 852 hours, the actual hours worked. The total cost for these total hours was for A grade 9.75 million. For B grade, total cost in rupees 2,982,000. Now, this is the actual information card, that's okay. Now, here you have to find out how much the number of hours per unit, because standard cost card will give information per unit basis. Let's take the first two sentences again. Two grade of labor work together in teams to produce product X. The standard composition of each team is 5 grade A employees and 3 grade B employees. Therefore, the mix will be 5 to 3 hours. Is that clear? To produce 1 unit of X, you required 5 hours of X and 3 hours of, not X and, 5 hours of B and 3 hours of A and B. Clear? Because X is the product name. To produce 1 unit of X, finished good. You have 2 labor A and B. From A you required 5 hours. From B labor you required 3 hours. This is the rate per hour. Therefore, this is the standard cost card for the product X. Not only that, there is another important sentence. After the standard information, they have mentioned output is measured in standard hours and expected output is 95 standard hours, that is 95%. 95 standard hours for 100 worked in total. What is it? When you introduce 100 hours, your expected output is 95. That means only 95% will be the output. What is this? Can you remember your process costing knowledge? You know, when there is a process of production, right? When you introducing input and getting output, there is a normal loss. They are explaining that normal loss. Why? When you introduce 100 hours, output will be 95 standard hours. That means 5% normal loss is there. Got it? That is the sentence. I will highlight also. You need to use that process costing knowledge also here. I think Suraj will add this into the presentation. The computer screen I have highlighted. Output is measured in standard hours and expected output is 95 standard hours for 100 hours worked in total. That is a norm. Moving into the white screen, the whiteboard, that means once you introduce 100 hours, your output will be 95. That means there is a 5% normal loss. Now, according to this question, in the output, the number of labor hours would be 5 from A and 3 from B. Therefore, the total number of hours will be 8 in the finished good. That is equal to 95%. Since there is a normal loss, you have to introduce 100% here, because this is 95%, right? You need to introduce 100% there. If this is 95%, how much the 100%? 8 divided by 95%, that is 8.4 you need to introduce, clear? Now, I will take you into the screen again. See the solution given, you can easily understand, right? This solution they have taken in the other way, the A labor 5, B labor 3. You can see, you can remember we have identified number of A labor 5 hours required, number of B labor 3 hours required. The price we have identified as 6000 and 4000, right? Then you can see there is additional calculation showing in the 174 page number, less 5%. Now, in this case, they have considered the other way. Other way, I will explain how they have considered. That is the normal loss, right? This is the output side. Now, this is the way, once you introduce 8, you can have 95, right? Now, this is the standard cost card. That means the amount you will introduce. Likewise, you can consider you will introduce A and B 5 hours and 3 hours. Then you will introduce 8 hours. It is 100%. If so, output will be 95%, the other way. Then you will have 95% from A and 95% from B. Total, you will have 95% of 8. Therefore, you need to require to reduce 5%, right? How much the 5%? 8 into 5% is 0.04. Therefore, this will be 7.6 hours. See, 8 into 95%, 8 into 95%, that is 7.6. You can take the both way, but you have to have assumption, right? Normally, when you introduce 100, you will be ended with 95%. Since this is the standard cost card, we can assume that is the input. If this is the input, you will be ended with 95%. Therefore, in the final output, this is the number of hours available. Is that clear? Right. Therefore, here you can say input, the standard cost card, 8 hours as a total, output expect 7.6 hours in the output. It also part of the standard cost card due to the normal loss. Okay. Now, let us see the questions raised by the examiner in that example. Moving into the computer screen again, direct labor total variance, then that is general calculation. Let us start with direct labor rate variance, because basically we will calculate labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance. Some of these basic variance will be the cost variance. Okay. Direct labor rate variance, now you can see the calculation. Here they are using the calculation way, no, without using the formula, but I will tell you the formula. The rate variance means, here this is rate variance. Rate variance means the difference between standard rate and actual rate, right? Since they have given the total cost, you can easily calculate, right? I will take the whiteboard again. The rate variance standard rate minus actual rate into actual hours, this is the sum of these two. This is the sum of these two. Therefore, no need to use the formula. Why? This is the total cost, actual information. This total cost means actual rate into actual hours, right? Actual rate into actual hours, that is this part. Therefore, to have the answer, you need to only do one thing. You need to take standard rate into actual hours, then difference will be the answer, right? Therefore, let us take standard rate into actual hours for A and B. Standard rate, what is the standard rate? This is 5 and 3. Now, your question, you can you use it, since you have a 5% normal loss. Once you introduce 8, you will be ended with 7.6. Therefore, to take the standard rate and actual hours, you have to do more calculation. I will take this table here and explain. Now, here 6000 rupees for 5 hours. But when you take A, when you introduce 5 hours, it will be ended with 95% of that. Got it? It will be ended with 95% of, because you have 5% normal loss. Therefore, 95% of 5 hours will be, 5 hours into 95% will be 4.75 hours. This cost for this 4.75 hours, right? 4.75, because once you introduce 5 hours, it will be ended with 95%. That's the issue. Then 4.75 hours will take by the product. That's the question. For B also same. Once you introduce 3 hours, will be ended with 95%. That is 2.7 hours. Is that correct? Let's see. 3 into 95%. 2.85 hours. Therefore, the cost per hour for this number of hours, not to this number of hours, since there is a 95%, no, sorry, 5% normal loss. Now, let us move into the answer. See the labor rate variance calculation for A and B here. This is item A, this is item B. Actual hours worked. Let us take actual hours.